Hello, hello, welcome back to my channel. My name is Sydney if you are new here. So today we are talking about organization, which will then lead you into a more productive life. And I'm just going to be giving you some tips that I've used in my business. If you clicked on this video, you definitely want to learn some tips on how to be more productive with your time. So this can help you with your personal business, with your day-to-day lifestyle. If you get off track often, even if you're in school, whatever it may be, this video is going to help you organize your time better to lead you into that productive lifestyle that you're looking for. Just to start off this video, I want to tell you guys that the average person has 6,000 to 8,000 thoughts per day, where we forget 50% of our thoughts in that same day and 90% within the week. So we are constantly thinking, our brain goes in a million different directions. This is a known fact. So how can you hold on to your thoughts and actually remember the important things and keep those at the top of your mind? So my first tip is to just write things down. Start setting reminders, start using platforms that are easy access to you. If you're a more hands-on person and you need to write things down, get a journal, get a calendar, and have it be small enough to fit into your bag. So I work through my phone, and I also work with a whole team, and they all say that I'm the organization queen, so hence why I got the inspiration to do this video. I keep myself organized in all aspects of life. I even have a purse organizer, okay? Like, I have an insert. I'll show you. I have an insert in there that literally has pockets in it so that I keep my purse organized. So even if you may not think that you're someone who needs to write things down and you're more digital, you like to type out lists, studies have shown that you process information in a much more detailed way when you actually write it down. So your brain works in a different way when you're writing it. I have this little journal. It's really cute. It's by Lavender. So I think she's a YouTuber or something. I honestly love this. So I'm the type of person that when I wake up, I do my morning routine, which I'm gonna get into, and I plan out my day. And I like planning out my day on paper. I don't know about you guys, but I just like organizing and I like planning things and making it cute and stuff. And so if something's not aesthetic, then I just won't do it. So this is a very aesthetic planner. And basically at the top, there's a little quote. You can put the date, you can circle what day of the week it is. I like this because it doesn't already have set days. So if you miss a day, it's okay. You can still use the page and it won't go to waste. It says, today I want to feel blank. And then it says today's focus. It gives you the most important tasks that you need to get done, and then your other to-do list. Then it also has a self-care section, so you want to make sure that you're not burning yourself out, that you're taking some time for yourself. So that's where I put my self-care. And then you also, it's really important to reflect on what you're grateful for. If you're someone who's constantly thinking negatively, 90% of our thoughts are actually negative. Like, those 6,000 to 8,000 thoughts that we have per day are mostly negative. And then finally, there's like a little note section. So I love this for planning each and every day. And then personally, I like having a digital and written calendar. So I also have another book where it's just a regular daily planner calendar type of thing. This is where I write my to-do list and my tasks that I need to get done. And then in the calendar, I write down dates and events that are happening. Other than my calendar and my daily task planner, I have a notebook. And this is basically just to write down, journal, reflect. Sometimes I like handwriting notes. That's just a miscellaneous notebook that I have as well. So those are like my little resources that I have, and I'll link everything that I use. So for my calendar, I use Time Tree, and I just like this because you can color code events, you can give yourself memos, you can write yourself a digital to-do list. And then I also use my Reminders app to remind me if I have a call or if I need to talk to a girl about the business, like, so I don't forget. So the next tip I have for you guys is to clean your external spaces. If you wake up to a messy room, if you're looking at your bed and it's not made, if you're looking at a pile of clothes that needs to be folded, if your desk's a mess and you can't find anything, how is that going to lead you to a productive and efficient life? So you have to make sure you take time to clean your spaces, because it's just gonna give you anxiety if you're just looking at clothes that in the back of your mind, that's just another thing that you need to get done. It's obviously easier said than done, but when you're sectioning your time, which I'm going to go into next, it's going to help you focus on actually getting stuff done in a productive manner. When you wake up and make your bed, you're already giving yourself a win. You woke up, you made your bed, you're feeling good. The next thing before I talk about sectioning your time is to have a morning routine. Whether you wake up at 5 a.m. or 8 a.m. or 11 a.m., try to wake up an hour earlier. Like if you have already a busy day, try to wake up an hour earlier so that you can take an hour for yourself to reflect, have some you time, do a little morning routine, maybe get some meditation in. So I have a video on my YouTube channel. It's just a vlog of a week of me waking up at 5 a.m. And let me tell you, I'm in the hardest phase right now and I've been slacking on it. I haven't been waking up at 5 a.m. but I'm still sticking to my morning routine and staying productive with my days and making sure that I'm getting stuff done. So give yourself time in the morning to plan out your day, reflect, meditate, work out, whatever you need to do, because if you're waking up an hour early, you have so much more time in the day and you just feel less rushed, less cluttered, less is on your mind. If you're taking that time for yourself to reflect and maybe get some things done. So I don't know about you guys, but in the morning, I'm the most productive. So that's why I love waking up at 5 a.m. Even though it is hard, it feels so amazing. And it's like working out, like you never regret working out. So you're never gonna regret waking up early and taking time for you. So the next thing I'm going to talk about is all about planning your to-do list and tasks that you need to get done. And it's very overwhelming sometimes when you just see a list of things you need to get done and then nothing ever gets done because you're like, you don't even know where to start. So the first thing I have for like feeling that overwhelm of, oh my God, like I have so much stuff to get done, I don't even know where to start, and then your brain just goes into like a defense mode. Your brain is programmed to be lazy, to always like go around the hard things, and your brain always figures out, okay, what's the easiest way to do this? Even if it's not the easiest way and the most beneficial for you, it's still thinking that way. So a tip that I have for figuring out what tasks you need to get done to actually hit your goals and get to where you wanna be is by mind mapping. So mind mapping works with a big goal or place that you wanna be in life, and then you kind of branch it out into what you need to do in order to get there. You're kind of going in reverse. And this is actually how your brain works, because instead of just writing down things to do, your brain doesn't work in a list. Like I said before, we have so many thoughts a day. Like your brain is constantly going into different directions. You're getting distracted, you're forgetting about things, right? It's going in a million different directions. So what mind mapping does is following the same structure that your brain already thinks in. So you start with a goal, you branch it down into what is going to get you closer to that goal. For example, let's pretend I wanna hit 1,000 subscribers. How am I gonna hit 1,000 subscribers? Okay, I need to get my views up. How am I gonna get my views up? And then you go along that branch, right? So how am I gonna get my views up? I'm gonna post 1 to 2 times a week. How are you gonna post 1 to 2 times a week? You need to come up with video topics. How are you gonna come up with video topics? You're gonna consult your friends. You're gonna post on your Instagram. You're gonna look up inspo that you like to watch. You're gonna figure out what your niche is. Okay, so these are like going down in that branch, and you're gonna do that with all aspects of life. And then once you get to the bottom of the mind map, the bottom of the tree, you take those little tasks, and then it's not as overwhelming as, I need to get 1,000 views. I don't know where to start. And then you procrastinate. You're saying, okay, I'm gonna get 1,000 views, but I'm gonna start brainstorming my next YouTube video. And then I need to film it. And then I need to edit it. And then you go up. Makes sense, guys? Great. Now with blocking time. So you wanna block things that are similar into the same time frame. So for example, right now, I am filming a YouTube video. I put some makeup on, I did my lashes, okay, I put on a cute top for this. It's a bodysuit, okay, it's not even buckled down there or tucked in or anything. I'm in like workout leggings because I'm gonna go to the gym after, okay? I'm being efficient with my time. But anyways, I'm going to block my content. So after I film this video, what am I gonna do? I'm gonna go talk on my story. I'm gonna go film a reel. Okay, because I'm already done. I'm gonna block my time in a way that makes sense. Ordering your to-do list in order of importance is called brain dumping. So you basically just dump a bunch of thoughts on a piece of paper of what you need to get done, and then order it in an order of importance. So I need to, I need to post a YouTube video. I've been slacking on YouTube. So what am I gonna put at the top of my list? film your YouTube video. Another thing I wanted to say is that there's a difference between being busy and being productive, because you could go out with friends, you could go get coffee when you don't need to. I mean, sometimes it's just good to get like a mental break, like I did today. I went to go get Starbucks because I had a bunch of calls in the morning, and then here I am, I'm still being productive with my time. If you're not being intentional with what tasks you're giving yourself and what events that you're giving yourself, you're never gonna go anywhere. You're just gonna be busy. But what does busy really mean? And you have to reflect on that. What does productive mean, and what does being busy mean? You have to know the difference. And you can never say, I don't have enough time, because you can literally make time for anything you want. Instead of saying, oh, I don't have time for that, you say, it's not my priority. So if your goals, if your success, whatever that means to you, success is different for everyone. If you're saying something like, oh, I just don't have time for it, well then it's not your priority, babe. You literally can wake up earlier, you can go to bed earlier, you don't have to watch Netflix, you don't have to hang out with your friends, you don't have to go get drinks, you don't have to scroll on Instagram for fucking 2 hours before you go to bed. You don't have to stay up till, okay, so you literally can create time for yourself. So I don't even want to hear you say, oh, I don't have time for that though, because you do. It's just not your priority. We all have the same 24 hours in a day. So if Jenny over here can have 3 kids, a full-time job, have her own online business, still make time for the gym, I think you can make time for whatever it is that you're telling yourself as an excuse you can't do because you don't have time. And you also want to know, because obviously, like, maybe waking up at 5 a.m. is not for you, because your peak hours are late night. You grind late night. Like, I have a friend who has his own business, shout out Jono, and he'll stay up, he'll take naps throughout the day because his peak hours are at like 3 a.m. when no one else is awake. For me, I rather go to sleep a little earlier and then wake up at 5 a.m. and that's my peak hour. Nobody's awake at 5 a.m. There's no distractions at that time. For him, there's no distractions, so he'd rather just nap throughout the day. There's also a Pomodoro technique. So the Pomodoro technique, I actually got introduced by Rob Dial, so shout out to him. I love his podcast. He does a lot of mindset work. He's called the Mindset Mentor Podcast. He talks about the Pomodoro technique, and you can look this up, but basically it's sectioning your time. So you actually like section whatever. If you want to take an hour editing a YouTube video or take an hour doing whatever it is, do it in 25-minute sections, like 25 minutes on, 5 minutes off, so that in those 25 minutes, you're doing nothing but your task, and then you're taking 5 minutes for a break to check your phone, get some water, go to the bathroom, whatever it may be. Because you might think, oh, 25 minutes isn't a lot, but if you're non-intentionally doing something, doing a task that is pretty important, and you're just aimlessly doing it unintentionally, we'd get distracted so easily. So if you're not tuned in, your phone's in a different room, like, you're most likely getting distracted by your phone or getting distracted by something. And a quote that I wanted to end this video with is by Robin Sharma, and he says, longevity is the key to legendary. You must learn how to balance working intensely and brilliantly with deep rest and recovery so you can remain fresh and strong over a long career. Yes, everyone needs time for reflection, but this doesn't mean letting yourself get off the hook all the time. Don't make that a habit. But when you're working hard and intensely, you need to give yourself that time to go to bed a little earlier, maybe one night, or give yourself that 25 minute on, 5 minute off rest period, because that is going to be the key to your productivity. Instead of trying to do something for 2 hours straight and you're feeling overwhelmed, you're burning yourself out, and then you don't want to do it again for another week because you hated doing that for 2 hours. Okay, so do things that you can do in longevity. Becoming productive, it's a lot of mindset work that you have to do, and really understand that you have the power to change all of your thoughts, and you have the power to change any negative into a positive. You're in the position to literally just transform the way you think. So do some digging on mindset work, and the only way to grow is by getting uncomfortable. The time you least feel like doing something is the best time to do it, because in order to grow, in order to make a change, you have to get uncomfortable, and you have to do the tasks that you don't want to do, that you know will get you to where you want to be, when you don't want to do it, because that's going to push you out of your comfort zone, and that's going to teach your body that eventually, over time and through repetition, your body is going to lock it in as a habit and lock it in as something that's comfortable so that those uncomfortable things won't be uncomfortable anymore. So that's it for today. Comment down below what your favorite tip was and definitely leave me recommendations for what you guys want to see in the future. And if this is your first time on my page, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and hit the notification bell as well if you want to get notified when I post new videos. I definitely need to be more consistent on here and that's one of my struggles, but I'm getting to it. And yeah, I hope you guys like this. Give it a thumbs up if you did. And follow me over on Instagram because that is my most consistent platform. I do provide a lot of tips and I go on rants sometimes about mindset and stuff like that. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you guys in my next video.